Thoughts on Revelation 14. The 13th chapter of Revelation and the first five verses of the 14th is one connected chain of past, present, and future events, down to the complete redemption of the 144,000. Then the sixth verse commences another chain of events which carry us down through the history of God's people in this mortal state. John had a view of the beast and his image as recorded in chapter 13, and how natural it would be for him to view on a little further and see the 144,000 who had gotten the victory over the beast and over his image, standing on Mount Zion with the Lamb, etc., as recorded in chapter 14, 1 through 5. So I think the division should be between the 5th and 6th verses of the 14th chapter, and the sixth verse commences a series of events relative to the successive messages of Holy Advent truth. All classes of Second Advent believers agree that the angel brought to view in the sixth and seventh verses of this chapter represents the Advent message to the church and world. If this is true, then all five of the angels brought to view in this chapter represent five distinct messages prior to the Advent, or we are left without a rule to interpret this chapter. The work of the second angel was to show to the Advent host that Babylon had fallen, and as a large portion of them did not learn this fact until the power of the midnight cry waked them up just in time for them to make their escape from the churches before the tenth day came on, it follows that the second angel brought us to the seventh month, 1844. The third angel's message was, and still is, a warning to the saints to hold fast and not go back and receive the marks which the virgin band got rid of during the second angel's cry. And has not the true message for God's people since the seventh month, 1844, been just such a warning? It certainly has. I cannot agree with those who make two messages of the cry, "Babylon the Great is fallen," and the voice, "Come out of her, my people," for every sermon that was printed or preached on this subject contained them both in one message. The 12th verse reads, "Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God," etc. Where did you see them, John? Why, here, during this third angel. As the patient waiting time has been since the 7th month, 1844, and as the class that keep the Sabbath, etc., have appeared since that time, it is plain that we live in the time of the third angel's message. The last two angels are messages of prayer. We shall, no doubt, better understand them at the time of their fulfillment.
Thank you. It's time.